first test in November is Lyman Hall on Thanksgiving Day, and we can finally talk about that game.
Right?
That time is coming. Okay? That means a lot. Now, we have Carini Bowl. We have Carini Bowl bragging rights on the line. How many we have in a row?
Five.
We want to make it six. But there's more implication on it this year. A win on Thanksgiving will guarantee what for the first round of the playoffs? A home game. Okay? A home game. Right? You want to play a game at home in the postseason when you can control it. We control our own destiny at this point. So there's a lot still riding on us. You know what? And now's where it gets fun. Now's where it gets fun.
Started their freshman year in the summertime, poring over the playbook. They would come after practice, after doubles, and spend every minute learning plays, practicing in the backyard with little Wes and little Andrew, and continued that discipline and that work ethic and that bond right through their senior year. So I've seen Evan mature not just as a player but as a brother to the rest of the small senior core and then the rest of the team mentoring. And he took away, I think, just this commitment to get better and this commitment to excellence. He's very hard on himself. If you know Evan, he puts more pressure on himself than any other team member. But he takes it really personally and takes that passion to the next level. And then when he was awarded captain, it was a dream come true for him. And watching that dream now translate with the passing of a great senior leadership team last year, there were a lot of unknowns. The press didn't give this team any credit, not a lot of chances to do much of anything. It was a transition year. That was the word thrown around by some coaches in the media over the summer. I think the seniors took that personally as a challenge to make it not a transition year in a tough way, but in a good way. And they really took it to heart that the brotherhood was going to succeed as a team. And Evans lived that every minute.
Yes, and he's very disciplined. He'd get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. We never heard that child complain, you know?
He liked to play.
That's good.
He liked to lift weight and everything. He didn't change the last two seasons. He's the same thing. He just liked to work and do his job.
I feel like the coaches expect them to be good people, to have good behavior, to have good grades. I mean, the coach sets a grade point average that he wants the team to meet as a team, and they do, and they have to turn their grades in. All their teachers know that if you have a problem with any of my players, I want to hear about it. So they're answering to other people, the coaches and their teachers and everybody. They want the same things from the kids that we want. So to have that reinforced in another place feels good. It backs up what we are trying to say here.
He's just taken off like a rocket. I mean, he's so far exceeded the expectations I had for him playing. I just thought it'd be great for him to be a team player, be out there having fun. But now he's a junior captain. He's starting on both sides of the ball. I mean, it's incredible what he's accomplished having not been on a football field before his freshman year.
It's me, and I'm not really a football fan, or I wasn't before, so kind of like, okay, you know, got out to the games, he did extremely well, and I was like, wow, that's my son. And then, you know, getting to this point this year, now it's very exciting, because, you know, watching him and the camaraderie of the team and just getting to know the kids that are like family to us as well, it's been quite the experience. I'm glad that, you know, they kind of twisted my arm a little, and I said yes.
Well, the funny thing is that when Steven had an interest in football, because he used to be a soccer player, and he came up to me the first time and said he wanted to play football, I thought he wanted to play flag. It never struck me that he wanted to play tackle. And his remark was, "No, Mom, I want to play tackle." I'm like, okay. So watching him start at fourth grade and work his way up, he's improved every single year. I'm very proud of him because, you know, when he was a Viking, and it wasn't so great in many years, but then they improved every single year.
I always like to push Luke to his limits because I knew he's always been a lot more athletic, especially for his size, because kids his size usually like don't pick up things that quickly. Like any sport he plays, he picks it up. Even lacrosse, like It's the same exact thing. He never touched a lacrosse stick in his whole entire life. Starts varsity his first year. And it's just, I just always love to push him and keep his competitive nature always on, like, to the highest peak I possibly could.
We've, this year really started when last year ended. We have a saying, December to December, which means when our season ends in or if you don't make playoff, your season ends on Thanksgiving. And we start training again in December. So it's a quick turnaround, but we start with our off-season lifting program, and we put a lot of work in the off-season. And, you know, any bad day, we keep saying, you know, we can't have these bad days because it's going to pay off. And it's starting to look like that. We are setting ourselves up for that. So our goal has been from the beginning of the season, we set team goals as captains, and the biggest priority was to qualify for playoffs and end the drought that hasn't been done in a long time.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's one of the things I like about football in general is the physicality of it. But definitely, like, being a unit with all the linemen has been great. Like, we're really tight-knit. As far as the position goes, yeah, it's just fun to get to play some football. It's where it's the trenches.
Football means a lot. You know, it's just something that kind of, you block out all the outside noise, and it's just something you can focus on and you enjoy having fun with your brothers. I mean, since it's my senior year, you know, you always want to have a great season to go out on, and you want to be remembered. So this is a season to be remembered, and we just want to have something special going on this year.
Well, it's there's a lot of school pride, and I think anytime you have a two-school town, you know, one school wants to be the one to maybe up the other one a little bit, but it's kind of, you know, we have this thing with presenting ourselves and presenting our colors and being proud of, you know, who we are and what we stand for. You know, and I really see just, you know, there's a close-knit feeling when it comes to players and community and family, no matter who you surround yourself with around here. And, you know, we just try to emulate that here within the program.
I mean, I didn't get to play it as a kid because I grew up with a cyst in my head. They found it when I was in, like, first or second grade. So my mom didn't want me to play. But then before high school, she got, like, confirmed by Yale that I was able to play. And it's helped me out a lot because I wasn't really confident as a kid because I was a bigger kid. But in high school, like, playing football, and I became, like better at it. It kind of gave me the confidence.
It's a huge part of my life. I mean, we go basically, our goal is December to December, which the coaches always harp on, and that's our goal. So it takes up the majority of our high school career, which is, it actually I think it's really good because you're not outside of school doing things that you shouldn't be doing. It really keeps you focused on school and brings a great camaraderie together.
Wes Terzi, he was kind of thrown into a tough situation, you know, sophomore year. You know, you're just really learning the varsity offense, and they say, hey, you're starting, so have fun. Wes is an extremely hardworking kid, and not only does he have an amazing eye for football and, like, brain for football, he understands routes, combinations extremely well, but also he is just naturally good at everything, and it's kind of annoying sometimes, but, like, everything he does looks extremely good. Fundamentally, he's extremely fundamental sound. He's just a really good football player.
Wes Terzi's he's a gamer too. We have a lot of gamers on the team, but I mean, he goes out there and he just throws the stripes down the field. I mean, he just gets the ball where it needs to be. He's a great leader. Like, when we're in games and it's kind of like it's a little shaky, he'll get, like, when we go to timeout, he'll say, all right, everybody bring in. He'll calm everybody down. He'll get his back situated. He's definitely one of those leaders on the team that people, unless you're on a team in the huddle, you wouldn't know. But he's really vocal.
Oh, yeah, it's great. He's been doing what he needs to do, and he's been progressing well. And he's really stepped up into the role. His big role to fill, and he's been doing a great job.
Well, last year, coming in as a starting sophomore quarterback is really tough for him. But I felt like it helped him grow up a little bit more, because this year now he's throwing perfect balls downfield and he's trusting the line more in the pocket. So we're proud of him.
Wes Terzi was in a situation last year where he kind of got thrust into starting quarterback role as a sophomore. But it couldn't have happened at a better time where, you know, Wes didn't have to be the guy. You know, we had some players on the team last year who were able to shoulder that role, and Wes's job was to manage the offense and distribute the football. And, you know, we had someone in the backfield that did a pretty good job with that in Zach Davis, and that allowed Wes to get the experience of varsity football from the quarterback position, you know, that where he didn't have to, so to say, shine last year. He didn't feel like he had to have the team on his shoulders, which gave him such a confidence going into this season where now he's ready for that, and he's done that pretty consistently all year. And, you know, what's best about Wes is his temperament for the position is good. He gets excited, but he never gets too high, and also he never gets too low. Through any mistakes he might make, a quarterback must stay level-headed, and he's been able to do that. He's extremely coachable, easy to work with, and it's been such a joy to work with him the last 2 years, and I'm just excited to get another year with him.
Will Terzi is an interesting character. He's been one of my closest friends since I got to high school. We spent a lot of time together on the freshman level and varsity. We kind of grew up in this program together, so it's Will is also up there with Steve for one of the hardest working people I've ever met in my life. The kid just gives 110% effort into everything he does, and frankly, I wish I could do that, because the kid will literally run himself into puking every single second, and I don't know how he does it. The kid's motor never stops.
Will Terzi is the epitome of a workhorse who will leave every last ounce and drop of his energy and his sweat on the field or in the weight room or in the classroom. You know, you'll never find him leaving any stone left unturned. You know, he's played so many different positions for us. Who'd have think that a person would come in and play quarterback as a freshman and he'd be playing on the offensive line on offense by his senior year? And to ask a quarterback to eventually become an offensive lineman, you know, that wouldn't appeal to most kids. And when you bring that situation up to Will, he's just like, okay, coach, whatever I have to do. And you can't have a successful football team without a large number of those kids. And Will is one of those guys. You know, his first position, his love position, is linebacker. And he's developed through that, through his work in the weight room and his attention to detail and really just getting those reps from last year where he started, you know, side by side with Danny James last year. And now he took Danny James's place. He's leading the team in tackles. He doesn't come off the field. He basically plays all the special teams. Never asked to come off the field. You know, it's players like that that you start your football team with, you know, who are willing to leave it all on the field every day.
Honestly, when we're out there, it's not, you obviously have that brother factor that, like, yeah, you know he's your brother, but like when I'm playing, I'm not like, oh, he's my brother, I have to do this, that, and that, or whatever. I just see him as another teammate. But I give him all the respect. Starting from as a freshman, he played quarterback, and then he got tossed around a little bit. And senior year, he ended up being an offensive lineman, which, yeah, I give him the total credit in the world for that.
Will, he's a little crazy sometimes. He pushes all of us to our like full extent. He always pushes himself too, and he's a good athlete.
Will Terzi's definitely the hardest working kid I've ever met. I mean, everything he does, just precise with technique and everything like that. He's a great athlete, and he's also a great leader. He knows what to do, and he'll do whatever coach tells him to do.
Steve's a powerhouse. Coming in freshman year, weighing like 120, like 5'8". Kid was scrawny, and then I think it was like mid-sophomore year, he just started lifting huge weight, and now he's just a force on the team. Steve Zenisky is, without a doubt, the hardest working person I've ever met in my life. He was obviously extremely light freshman year. He told me, Will Terzi, and Nathan Zona in the locker room our freshman year that junior year he would squat 405 pounds. And Steve's always been a dreamer, you know, and we were all, you know, joking around, okay, Steve,
And not only did he squat 405, he squatted 500. He is an amazingly hardworking kid, and he has really become one of the centerpieces of our team.
Steve Zenisky, there's never been a bigger transformation of someone, both physically and mentally, since he's gotten here. I think when he reported as a freshman, he was probably 130 pounds. And now he's probably in that 270 to 275 range, standing as the strongest player by the numbers that we've ever had in the program as far as what our strength program does. You know, so the work speaks for itself. You know, he's put the work in to be the player, you know, that he's being this year. You know, he's been really dominant on both sides of the ball, and he's put himself in a position to be very successful. But on top of that, he's grown, he's matured since that time when he's come in. And you know, we're very proud of him. He's a joy to be around. He's so coachable. He's so positive. He never gets down on himself or anyone else. He's always looking at the brighter side of the coin. And you know, it's because of kids like him that we're in a good place.
Yeah. So Steve was always a big kid in youth. Played offensive line and defensive line. But then towards the end of middle school, he lost like a lot of weight. I know he had like a little bit of an issue with that. But and then he played receiver coming in for us and defensive back as a freshman. But he's really committed himself back to like becoming like where he naturally plays, which is an offensive lineman, and just eating right and lifting weights and get like becoming just a freak in the weight room and squat rack.
Steve, he's kind of a character. You know, everyone knows Steve because, you know, he dresses a little goofy to school or whatnot, but when it comes game time, he's a whole nother breed of animal. I mean, he goes out there, he tears it up, and he's a great teammate, a really nice kid.
Yeah, Luke, one of the things I love about Luke, as Wes said, was he knows, he's like one of the funniest guys I know, but he knows how to be serious when it's time to be serious, and he can really dial it in, make sure everyone's focused and keep everybody in line, but still be a guy that, like, is easy to talk to and lightens the mood.
Luke Willette is one of my best friends. He brings an extreme competitiveness into everything he does, and he is also extremely hardworking. You know, he's always in the weight room. He's probably the most vocal of the leaders. We all lead in very different ways, but he's probably the most vocal of the leaders, and he's kind of like the macho man of the group. You know, he's bigger guy, but he's awesome.
That seems like he's been here for 5 years already, and we still have another year with him. You know, his personality is infectious. He's got such a great energy about him where, you know, he can always bring an excitement and an intensity to both not only himself and the coaches, but his teammates as well. He's worked extremely hard at his craft. He's so reliable, and he's just a junior. And with all those things, he was able to be named. He got named a junior captain this year. I think we're in a fortunate situation with him where we get to have him for another year. But to see, you know, where he's, when he came in and where he was as a freshman to where he is now already, he's functioning as a senior, and yet he has another year left with him. We're excited about that. His whole aura and his personality, it brings such a good dynamic to the three captains, where I think that's going to help him even being a better leader for us the following year.
Luke Willette's a funny guy. He's one of the he's the clown. He's the class clown, if you want to say, of the team. He's always making jokes and everything like that. He's making everybody laugh. But I mean, he knows when to flip the switch, when to turn it on. He's a hard worker. I mean, we take everything seriously. He's one of the hardest workers on the team, and he goes through every practice. We all demand excellence, but he does too.
Evan, definitely a playmaker. He always gets a little criticized for being slow, but I don't really see him that slow. He's definitely gotten faster. Great, reliable receiver for me. Great friend on and off the field. Awesome leader. So, yeah.
Evan, yeah, one of my best friends. Super smart on the field. You can tell he loves the game, same as all of us do. But he's really smart. He's a real leader out there. He plays with everything he's got. And yeah, he's a playmaker too.
That kid like runs the defense. He knows everything that every position needs to do. and he's always helping us out.
I mean, Evan, all the guys were best friends. I mean, Evan's one of those guys that he's just a gamer. I mean, he'll go out there. If he's not feeling so good, he's one of those guys you know will always be there and play no matter what. I mean, he's a great athlete, and I mean, he just makes plays.
We're trying to develop, you know, young men on and off the field. You know, part of the policies of what we have in their program in terms of how we make them responsible, keep them responsible, hold them accountable, and put them into life situations, you know, is really, really something that we feel strongly about. And sometimes early on, you know, it takes them a while to make that connection. But as they get to their upper class years and those junior and senior years, they start to realize, you know, how much better the experience, you know, through football really makes them when it comes to, you know, sacrifice and commitment and being dedicated to something that's bigger than just them. And that's something they could take with them forever.
To say the least, you see everyone come out for you. There's trash talking all year. Like, and you could have the greatest season, you could have the worst season, but sometimes it seems like that game is all that matters for the guys who don't have as good of a season. It's like a mini Super Bowl. It's awesome.
It's exciting that, you know, I was on the other side as a rival for the school. But to see my own son, you know, it's exciting this year, especially being his senior year, to see him participate in it. I mean, he did participate in last year too. It's exciting to see how they play and to make that big win for them.
I think that there's always going to be the first quarter, the first half, it's going to be played with emotion. I know our coach Steve says it's first quarter is played with emotion, purely. And I would agree with that. They're not going to be focused on Sheehan's 8-1, we're going to pack it in. They're going to be focused on Sheehan's 8-1, let's do what we can to beat them. So we're going to do everything we can to prepare for them so that we don't let that happen.
And so far, these boys have made everything work this year, so. You know, even their one loss was one of the best games I've seen them play. You know, go down into prep, a double L school, and in their home, and be tied 2 minutes into the fourth quarter.
I think we're preparing the same as far as like schematically and like what we're thinking about and making sure we're all watching film for that. But yeah, I think Lyman Hall is the first task at hand, and then after that, we'll worry about the playoffs.
Knowing that you can keep a streak going is important. You know. Even in years where both Lyman Hall and Sheehan maybe didn't have winning records, this game still means a lot. To win the Carini Bowl is like a separate championship in itself. And it doesn't mean anything outside this community. But what's in this community is very important. We've won 5 in a row, and we're very proud of that. And you know, I'd be lying to say that 6 is it wouldn't be important to us. But we got to continue to do the things that got us there and able to get in order to get that. And we are fully focused on that.
But we also know the boys on the other team. They have friends, and so I think somebody said
good
it
kids.
In an interview for Powder Puff, and they said, "You know what? We're for each other until we play each other."
Right.
You know?
Yeah, yeah.
And really, it's you know as much as you want to win.
You know what's?
It feels bad.
William's freshman year, Lyman Hall's freshman team came and played us at Sheehan. And destroyed them. And this year, so William's first big game, they had a chance to play Lyman Hall at our field. William's last regular season big game, they'll have a chance to play Lyman Hall at, and hopefully exact some revenge a little bit.
It means a lot. I mean, especially from my class, freshman year, we got destroyed by Lyman Hall. And a lot of the guys that we used to play with went to Lyman Hall instead of Sheehan, even guys that were on this side of town. And a lot of it is just like, we're ready to give a little payback this year. And I mean, you always want to win. You always want to win on Thanksgiving. It's a big game. There's a lot of people that watch. It's just a lot of fun, too. If we win this year, it'll be 6 years in a row. I mean, that just shows how hard we work and that the way that Coach Rozzi has turned a program into a successful program. And we're just looking to, we're consistent. We work hard and we start to show off this season. You can see how we're playing.
On the final night of practice, Coach Ferrazzi and his staff ran the boys through their paces, got them ready for the game tomorrow, not only physically, but mentally. And as they thought to themselves, what will tomorrow bring? There was a certain confidence and excitement that came over the team. The seniors on this team had worked for years to get to this point. Coach Ferrazzi, even more. and all they wanted to do was bring home another Carini Bowl win to represent their school. But even more important than placing that trophy on Mr. Daly's desk is the relationships and the skills that they've learned through this program. And on the final night, they gather around the field in darkness around a burning shoe where they talk about what the program has meant to them and what they meant to each other. And while we don't know what that mystery actually is, many boys become men because they know that the next day, very next day, on a few hundred feet away, they'll have to defend their honor as a football team, as a school, as a player in the Carini Bowl, where Lyman Hall was coming to their field. And no matter how high the expectations were, they'd have to win it themselves the next day. Came out in force on a brisk but sunny Thanksgiving day. Students, teachers, parents alike, all came to watch the game. A united and dedicated team stood together during the national anthem. Equally as dedicated were the visitors, the Lyman Hall Trojans, prepared long in advance for this game and would like nothing better but to take the win home for themselves. Early on, Sheehan's offense, led by Wes Terzi, put some impressive points on the board. Yet Lyman Hall showed the grit and toughness that they're known for, scoring as well. As Sheehan returned to the locker room, a confident team was up 28-7. The halftime show from the cheerleaders and a combined Lyman Hall Sheehan band gave us a pause in the action. Coach Ferrazzi got his team prepared for an early Lyman Hall push, knowing that they'd come out with vigor and energy to try and even the side. Despite all their hard work, Lyman Hall just didn't have the answer to the Sheehan puzzle, and Sheehan was able to come away with the victory.
Great game, good energy. We got the team behind us supporting our team.
McCarthy and Terzi, Terzi on the stop.
It was a team with skill. Skilled coaching, skilled players, who played with sportsmanship and class.
Number 34, Terrence.
It was a privilege to be out here today and see two great teams compete. The teamwork the sportsmanship, the athleticism, your talent. Absolutely speaks for itself. We are proud of every one of you. Today, she's the Titan, wins the Carini Bowl.
Feels amazing. We really came together as a team.
It feels great. You know, we put in a lot of work for it, and we planned very hard for this. And
I mean, it wasn't our best win, but it feels pretty good. We'll take an ugly win over a pretty loss any day of the week. We're gonna go into the film room tomorrow, practice, and then we're gonna look forward to the playoffs now.
A little shaky in the beginning. I think it was just. I had the jitters, and I was really just not really focusing, but went in there halftime in the locker room, really just got my mind straight and came out to play.
It feels great. Yeah, it's amazing. It's great tradition, always getting out here. We always dream of beating Lyman Hall as much as you can.
I'm excited, you know, the adrenaline's pumping. And now we got to keep working, come back in tomorrow, get ready for our first round playoffs.
Yeah, it's any Thanksgiving Day victory is, it's just a great program victory. Thanksgiving is special in Connecticut, and it's even more special in Wallingford with the rivalry with Lyman Hall being a two high school town. So it's special, and it just makes it even more special to win six in a row and keep it here.
They played a phenomenal game. You got to give them credit coming out here, working hard, and giving us a good game.
Yeah, they always come out ready to play. I've never seen a team on either side come out not ready to play on Thanksgiving. So.
Yeah, I thought the two backs were tough. Tougher than I thought they would be. You know, not that watching film, I didn't think they were tough, but they ran the ball hard, they were physical, and they fought for yards. They definitely made that first half, you know, definitely stressful on my part, calling defense.
And so they accomplished their goal of a sixth Carini Bowl and a playoff berth. And next year, they're looking to do it all over again.